with some of that laid back, you know.
What am I talking about again?
Feel like, yeah.
My name is Lilly. I go by the stage name of Superwoman, and I make YouTube videos. I bake. I try to rap. I dance. I do a whole bunch of cool things, and I'm here to tell you some messages I'm really, really passionate about. But before I do that, I think we need to give a super, super big round of applause to the organizers of this event. Because it's one thing to have a beautiful idea, but then to act upon it is something amazing. So please give them a huge round of applause. Thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. Her joke and Rick, thank you. And before I begin, I'm a pretty fun person, like my friends usually tell me I'm fun. So, yeah, woo! So, anywhere along my talk, if you want to clap, cheer, cry, throw something, whatever, please feel free to do so. Interact with me, that's totally cool. Now, the first thing I want to talk about is something I actually mentioned in the video, and that's how I started my YouTube videos. And I want to talk about this because it goes hand in hand into how I became this positive person, or so I'm told. And basically, I know that, you know, we have our Just Raids and AKs, they're awesome and I love them. Give it up for Just Raid AK, go on, awesome. But I really, really felt like, why isn't there a girl talking about the female perspective? So when I get asked in interviews, you know, that's my scripted answer, because Just Raid and AK were doing it, so now I want to do it. But now I'm gonna tell you the truth of actually, it's because I came out of a very, very difficult time in life. And like everyone else, I'm sure we've had our ups and downs, you know, we feel down on certain days. But I was at a significant down for a very long time. And somehow, someway, I picked myself up. And when I looked around, what upset me was there were so many people around me who felt just like me, who for some reason are unhappy. They feel unpretty, whatever they may feel. And to me, that did just not fly. I truly wanted to send the message of, you know, whatever you're going through, you will get through it. You are beautiful, no matter what anyone tells you, whether it's, you know, you don't get along with your parents, or the guy at school doesn't like you. Yes, uncles, aunties, girls like guys, it happens. Okay, whether they don't like you, that you are beautiful. So if you take away one thing from this event, besides the free John Samosas in the lobby, I want you to remember that you are absolutely beautiful. It is my personal goal to tell you that. You are beautiful. I mean, I have almost 20/20 vision. I'm looking at you guys. You guys are hot right now. You guys are beautiful to me right now. Okay, next I'm gonna talk about another thing that was mentioned in the video. And before I say this, I wanna say that my parents actually are here right now. Give a round of applause for my parents. Actually, they're sitting right there, so you can turn around and look at them. They're sitting, oh, right on my back, right there, they moved. Right there. And I'm gonna pick on them a bit, but don't worry, I'm gonna do justice to it. So for those of you that don't know, I used to be, not anymore because I'm old, but I used to be a Bhangra captain for a co-ed team. So when I came up with this idea of my Bhangra team, I was so excited. I was like, I'm gonna be a millionaire, I'm gonna take over the world with my Bhangra team. I came home, and mom, dad, stop what you're doing. I have an amazing idea. I'm going to have a Bhangra team perform at weddings. And I was like this. And then they looked at me like this. And they said no. And they said, there is no way you are performing at people's weddings. And how many times have you heard this? Because what will people think? Girls can't dance at people's weddings. I then tried to live in my room for a week. But that didn't work too well. And like everyone else, I got into that fight where, you know, it's, I want to do this, why won't you let me do this? And so what I'm here to tell you is that, now don't throw anything, let me finish the sentence first. Kids, you are not wrong. Okay? But parents, you are not wrong either. What I want to stress is that neither of you are wrong. You're just different. You grew up in a different time and place and you have different mentalities. And what I want to say to all you daughters out there who want to dance and who want to draw and want to sing and want to do anything, as an artist, it is your job to show your parents why you want to do that. You know, for all those people that say, oh mom, I'm going to go study at the library, you really go to dance practice? I understand. I'm sorry for exposing you. But I understand that's easy to do, but it does nothing for the battle that we're fighting. If you want to do something, you look that challenge in the face and you do something about it. You say, you know what, mom? I want you to come to my dance practice with me and see that I'm not talking to boys. I want you to come to my performance and I want you to see what I do. And it wasn't until I performed for my family and they saw me perform that they said, you know what? Maybe she's not a failure and maybe she's good at this. So I want you to fight for your passion. And I'll tell you something personally as well. And I'm not just saying this because I'm scared right now. My mom is my best friend. She is my absolute best friend. And I tell her everything. You too, Dad, but I just, it's the mother-daughter thing. So there's nothing I do that my mom does not know. Every single thing I do, she knows. Everywhere I go, she knows. And who I go with, she knows. And so I have that relationship where I can openly tell her things. Now that doesn't mean she doesn't get mad. There's sometimes when I tell things and then I run very fast because she gets mad. But that means that I don't want to lie to her about things. And I know that's easy for me to say because I am fortunate enough to have parents that are a bit liberal. So what I want to say to you parents is that, and this might scare you a bit, but I'm going to tell you the truth. In this day and age where we live, there's millions of drugs your kids could do. There's millions of gangs they could join. They could be doing the most terrible things right now. So if your daughter wants to dance, you are blessed. Trust me, you are blessed. I mean, for us kids as well, it's hard. We're in the middle of an identity crisis. Even today, I didn't know whether I should wear pajama jeans or running shoes. And it's a hard decision every day of who we are. So you need to help us out a little bit. Now the next thing I want to talk about, thank you. Now the next thing I want to talk about is a video I did. I released it, I think, 2 days ago maybe? It's about girl-on-girl hate. Now, I don't know what it is about girls when we feel the need to hate each other so much. You know, you go to a family party, all the uncles will get together, go into the room, do what uncles do, the brothers and the sons. And the aunties will come and then, you know, say hi, whatever. But then as soon as you go home, it's like, they'll talk about people, right? They'll say that. So I want to say that I challenge each girl here to go against girl-on-girl hate. It's such a common problem where you go anywhere and girls are just giving you that look like they hate you. And my question to you is, we go through so many obstacles as is, why would we make it harder and hate on each other? How many times have you gone somewhere and guys are talking about a girl? They're saying bad things. I got in a fight with my dad. I did this. Why would we not support one another? So I'm going to show you. I'm going to leave my example right now. Okay? I'm going to show you how easy it is to compliment people. I'm going to just come right here. I'm just going to put someone on the spot right now. I'm going to come over here. Okay, so hi. I've been up there for a long time. What's your name?
Serena.
Serena, nice to meet you. And you have like the world's most beautiful smile. You actually do. Please, can you stand up? Can you, everyone clap for a smile right now. Great. Yeah, easy that was. Like, I didn't die. It felt good. She feels good. Everyone's happy. And to the parents, what I want to say is that your kids learn things from TV, internet, Facebook, Twitter, Blogger, Sarakot, but they also learn from you. So please lead by example, and when you go to family functions, don't go home and start talking about the auntie and everyone else. I know it's just odd, I know it's our culture, but they will learn from you. The love and peace you teach them, that's how they'll be. So please, please lead by example. And I just want to finish up on a general empowerment note, and that is all my daughters, I'm sure not my daughters, but daughters of people here, I'm sure you can relate. If your mom, particularly your mom, probably your dad as well, has ever said, you can't do this, you're a girl, this is the way it is. When I was younger, I never got to do it, and you're not going to be allowed to do it because that's the way it is, and things will never change. I don't know if you've ever heard that. My mom wanted to be a singer. She's not a singer right now. But she always tells me, if I couldn't sing, why should you be allowed to do this? But what I want to tell you is that we know, I commend all the mothers in particular here because I know you grew up in a day and age that was probably very difficult to grow up in. You're probably oppressed, you probably didn't get to take your singing classes, mom. And I absolutely, truly, please give it up for the moms who've gone through so much and just, yeah. So what I'm saying to you is that why would you not want to fight for your daughter to be able to do all those things you were not allowed to do? And so what I want to say to you is, I know you think things will never change. Well, 10 years ago, I was standing here making YouTube videos with this chain in my pants. Bullets would have been flying 10 minutes ago, and I would have been dead right here. And the fact that I haven't been assassinated yet means things are changing. And what I want to say is, when you have a daughter, celebrate her birth. You know, have a loni for your daughter. Don't participate in dowry. Treat your sons and daughters equally. Encourage and support them, because I'm not telling you to change the entire world, but I'm saying if you change your small world, you have the ability to change the entire world. So please encourage your daughters. Tell them to follow their dreams. I'm going to finish up again with what I mentioned in the video. I believe that every one of life's problems can be solved without hate, without fear. Please live with peace and love. I love you all so much. Thank you so much. It's an honor to speak for you. I appreciate it so much. Thank you.
Representations of women that she has put out on the online media for a lot of girls have become an amazing voice, and thank you. If you haven't seen Liz's last video, she preaches more love, less hate. I think that's the message of tonight. More love, less hate.